Good, fine. This, of course, is a piece of quite stern and dramatic intent, isn't it? And he writes Allegro moderato, so I'd be very careful right at the beginning not to shift the tempo too much at the beginning. Also, I think the importance of those left-hand quavers, be very careful that we hear the last of them. I think you shape them nicely, but to me, I heard the fourth one, the third of the quavers, moving a little bit fast. Can we just try the opening again? I would place this. There's your opening theme. So the ornamentation is just accentuating that placement, isn't it? It's a dramatic statement of the arpeggio. It's like, also sprach Zarathustra. So Strauss. Just try that once more. That's right. The cadence. last one's a crotchet, if that's correct. So don't rush off that last one. It gives you the colour of the cadence. Good. Okay, now this is back to a style that's more like the earlier, the Haydn period. Do you know the sonatas of C.P.E. Bach? Some of them? Yes, because they're highly wrought with intricate little phrasings and things like that. So I think this is, when you're looking at that type of Haydn here, make sure we're still getting that slur. So we're still hearing it. And then it comes of, what I'm saying is, it's made up of little units. And although they have to be joined, don't rush over them. It's nice if we can hear how the unit's finished. Let's just try that again. From there, can we go? That's right. So we hear how we need to shape each in a unit. So let's do it once more. Changes. It's nice, I like what you're doing here, but here you need to do a little bit more. You do it to place, so we still hear the line continuing through. Can we do it once more? From there. Place. Cadence. It might be simpler just to go from F sharp to the G, but you can think about that because it's not quite clear your ornament at the end. Can we do this? Yeah, it might be simpler just from the upper auxiliary because of the repeated F sharp. Haydn's turns are normally from the upper note, that sort of thing anyway, but maybe a D. Anyway, let's go on for the moment. Good. That's quite dramatic, isn't it, Jane, all that? I think if you want to, you can give yourself a little bit more time each time the big chord comes. So it speaks each time. Are you rolling each one or just the first one? Each one is rolling. Yeah. You make them even more dramatic. Quite big moments. Thank you. to even hear. Do, 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 do. So I hear it. You know what I mean by finger piddling? Just the lower of the. Do, 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 do. Just a tiny link so we get the harmony underneath it. Without using fingers. Now. Do, 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 do. Then very, very energized. Left hand. Go on. Good. You can play, give yourself time, even a little bit, split second, for the placement of your minim. The gesture each time. Dayam, dayam. So just a split second more, I think, to place it. Good, that's nice. Well, I feel we hear those shifts of harmony more easily. Do you feel that simpler like that? It gives a bit more space, doesn't it? And it makes it more rhetorical. That's important, that top note placement. And also gives time for the left hand to finish. To speak each time. Should we do that once more? Dayam. To hear. Dayam. Same again. Place the top E. Time to do that. We'll go from the beginning. From the C, can we? One more thing here, when you come to this new texture with the semiquavers, time to place those. So, time just to those wider intervals. Just for the harmony. Don't do it with rubato, though. Just do a tiny bit, then into tempo. Otherwise it sounds indulgent, I think, rhythmically. Go back to here. I'd like a bit more space on those ornaments, though. Da-da-da. Memory is as mordants, aren't they? And remember, mordant is the French word meaning from the verb to bite, mordre, mordant, biting. So exactly on the whole harpsichord, that's exactly what it was. Because remember, in the classical period, the ornaments are much more lyrical, but in the Baroque period, they are mostly, well, unless in long notes, they're going to be like a rhythmic definition, so defining a rhythm, defining that sort of thing. That's where the word mordant comes from. And although Haydn obviously is not writing in the Baroque period, the tradition is still very strong, and when he was writing that, that type of ornament is very much from an earlier period, I think. Do you want to try that again? So we need to hear each one speak. Don't rush them. That's it. First one, dum 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 dum, needs to be very pretty. present in the sound. Dum pom 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 pom, like cello, really, isn't it? Good. You can make more of your left hand. It colours it nicely. It answers it. Shall we go back to the octaves? Da-da-rum. Because we've still got to think within a context of the instrument he was writing for. And okay, we don't want to imitate because the instrument has changed, obviously. But I think in the fortes, be very careful, it's a full sound rather than forced in any way. Also at the top, I think you can do more with that lovely moment. Those harmonies. I liked what you did here. You give yourself time. Place. It won't sound wrong out in the hall as long as you're then in time. Should we just try that? I wouldn't mind going once more from here, though, Jane, into that, the octaves. Back in here, we just hear the line. I thought that was getting all a bit heavy there. If you just swing it. Just let the hand free up a little bit. So that these top phrases. Just free and swung in the hand. That'll play it for you. That'll play the dot, you see. It flicks it round. Dum da da dum ba da dum da da dum. Because it was getting a bit. Heavy at the top finger, I heard, but same at the top of the page. Sorry. All the just da da dum. So the top little note doesn't jump out of the phrase. Should we go once more from here? I think there I'd have a little bit, yeah, on the left hand. Too heavy fifth finger. We're hearing because of the textures, which would have been a forte piano, presumably. So. Have you played a forte piano? So you know what it sounds like. It has quite big register changes, doesn't it? Once more from there. Soften it away. Now let it lighten it. That's it. Nice. That's lovely. There you go. Now you can intensify it. Mm-hmm. finish the phrase. Plenty of time. That was really nice, I thought, those businesses here. Really nice. Should we do it again? From there? Oh, sorry, the octave one. Yeah. That we're listening for is when the right hand is then taken over by the left hand in rhythm. Something you can hear to make us listen to. So from the first one, drum, bom, bom, bom. So it's beautifully balanced. And then we hear as a listener, all these little things, they all join up and they complement. Let's go back to. And because I say that, it's because you're phrasing from that first quaver. Dom, 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 bom, 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 do, 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 do. And then it's coherent musically. Should we do it once more? Can we go from? Possible to. If you want to, give a little more space to begin each of those triplets, rum, each time if you want to, because in the hall we will hear that with great clarity. Can we go back to here? I wasn't sure what you wanted here. It says crescendo, but that may not be original. But are you going to take it away? Are you going to do this? Shape it away, or do you into the cadence? You have to decide. What do you think you like? Yeah, going into that, I think it's more exciting, especially as he's building up. And I think it leads us into that. Do you want to try that somewhere? And. So, it's a little bit rushed, isn't it? Bit of time. Now, see, we're doing time. Good. this one with the left hand. So we need to hear. Dum, dum, bum, bum. That's what the ear picks up. Should we try once more just to finish? Go back to. Can you go from. Da 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 da. Dum, dum. That's just a few thoughts just to enhance moments of the rhetoric in the piece, because it's a dramatically charged piece. Thank you for doing that. Great, thank you.
Thank you so much, Terence.
Oh, good. Thank you. Good. Thank you for coming.
Tonight, it's Masterclass by Peter Zerlin at 6 o'clock here.